What's going on, Sagittarius? Thank you to everyone who's liked, shared, subscribed. If you guys have purchased a reading or donated to my page, I appreciate you. We're going to check and see who's tugging on your energy. Thank you guys for finding me once again. This is somebody who is very in tune with your energy. Okay, I feel like you're in a place of really, Sagittarians, honing down on everything that is yours, pulling back your energy from people, places, and things where it doesn't need to be. I feel like you are really guarding your energy at this time, and this person feels it. They feel that you're disconnecting. They feel that you're walking away. They feel like you're not interested in them anymore. You're not giving them the energetic love that you always have, right? That attention that you always have. And this person is like, you know, little by little, I just feel a little less and less of Sagittarius. This is a person that's in a relationship with another person. They've been attached to this person for quite some time. This is some sort of karmic union with this person over and over again. The person that's thinking of you, they're not learning their lessons with this person that they're with. So they're repeating a lot of different cycles, right? They're staying stuck, stagnant. Their life is not going the way that they need it to go because they refuse to do things in a different light. They feel like their way is the best way, but they haven't understood. Like the definition of insane, right, is to continue to do the same thing over again, expecting a different outcome, okay? So someone here is just not getting it, right? They don't like that you are disconnected from them, but they don't want to make any changes in their life, which would give you the incentive of reconnecting with them. I don't know who I'm talking to right now. We have I ride by your house to see if you're still single. So this person may be relatively close to you. I may not be far from where you live. And they may do drive-bys to see if there's any cars that they don't recognize in your driveway or around your door. They want to know if you've moved on because they feel like if you haven't at this point, that spell work that they're sending towards you is working. That mental manipulation that they send towards you is working. And they feel like they want to keep you as detached as possible because that gives them an in, to come back towards you, okay? Right? They're watching you to see if you've moved on, you know, on one end, and on the other end, they're watching you to see if that shit they're doing on the side is working, okay? I feel like it's not working. I feel like you haven't moved on, Sagittarius, because you don't want to move on. In the wrong capacity. I feel like it's very important for you to choose correctly right now. And that's what you're doing. And I feel like this person just doesn't get it. I feel like this person's ego is everything to them. And it may get them in trouble a lot. And their ego is coming through with this reading because they feel like, okay, everything I'm doing on my side is really what's keeping Sagittarius single or keeping them detached in the capacity that I want them to be. But nothing that they're doing right now is working. You are totally protected by all that bullshit they're doing. And their ego just feeds them to the point where they feel like, yeah, I'm the man or I'm the woman because, yeah, you know, even though I have commitment issues, you know, I'm going to make sure that they don't get committed so that they're accessible to me. And this person wants access to you, but they don't want to give you nothing else. This is not a future. This is not them sharing their resources. This is not them being that person that you need in your life, Sagittarius. I'm just going to keep it a buck with you, okay? They're not giving you shit, all right? This person has not contributed to your life in any way. Nor will they do that if they come back. But they feel like they're so big on themselves that no one else matters but themselves, right? This is someone that you really had to see for who they are, okay? You may not have liked who you saw once you really, truly opened your eyes to this person, right? This person wants to know what you're doing. Spirit is telling me that they're not going by your house in their vehicle. They may have other people ride by, or if they have a vehicle that you don't know about, they use that vehicle. So in other words, if they bought a new vehicle since last you spoke to them, you won't know that it's them. Windows are tinted, by the way. Okay? Windows are tinted. Spirit just told me. So you're not going to know it's them when they go by, even if you're looking at the vehicle. Yep. So this person is very clingy to you. Thank you, Spirit, for coming through. Not letting go of the attachment that they have with you, but they feel like that attachment is getting thinner and thinner and thinner and thinner, and they don't like this, right? This is a person that gave you a lot of different conflicts. You may have had a lot of different arguments or discussions with this person. They're currently in a conflict with the person that they're with, right? They're still going through those karmic lessons. They're not ready to be in union with you. However, they're trying to figure out what chance they can take when it comes to you. And the chances right now that they're taking is riding by your house, right? And there is a chance that you could see them, etc. But right now, the thing that's on their side is that their windows are tinted, and you don't know that car that they're in, okay? I just got to keep it a buck with y'all. And yeah, this is crazy. This person didn't show you that they had a commitment issue. They may have told you that they want to be in a commitment, or may have led you down a path of feeling like they were commitment worthy. But this is the mask of that person. Was wearing. They didn't want you to know that they had some sort of codependency type of issue that they were dealing with either, right? They could have been a gambler, could have been taking drugs, could have been in violent situations, or they could have been codependent on another person, place, or thing, okay? They didn't want you to know that side of them. This is also a person that's dealing with inner childhood wounds. Bad childhood, poor relationship with their parents, they felt neglected, abused, abandoned, or they're still going through emotional immaturity because of it. But this person is dealing with their husband or their wife. Okay? They didn't tell you that they were married. Okay? For some of you, this is a spiritual marriage. For some of you, this is an Islamic marriage. For some of you, this is something that is not easily trackable. So they may get away with a lot of things. They could have had a physical ceremony to where they had a spiritual wedding, etc. So in the eyes of, you know, the universe, this is a married couple. But on paper, it may not be easy to find a record of what it is that they're in. So they know that they can get away with murder. This is the energy that's coming through. Right. Oh, yeah. If somebody looks up, they're not going to see that I'm married, because that's not the type of marriage that I'm in. But what they don't realize is that the type of marriage that they may have put themselves in is way deeper. Right. Spirit is trying to get them to still own up to the rules, the regulations, the things that they signed on for, but they're not doing it. So that karma that they're getting now, those karmic situations that they're stuck in, is because of it. Right. Yeah, you told the universe that you wanted to make an investment in another person, that you wanted to watch this grow, right? But you are out here giving other people your energy. Yeah, the universe doesn't like that, okay? So this person now is sitting there saying, how can I make things that I want come to fruition, right? How can I get back with this Queen of Swords energy that has cut me out of their life and said, you know what, go fuck yourself. Air sign or Virgo could be significant for someone here, okay? How can I get back in tune with the person that I care about when they got that sword up and they're going to slice my ass, I go back towards them, right? How can I do that, right? How can I make a right decision here? How can I stand up to this person or go towards them and tell them what my needs or wants are? How can I do it? I've suffered a loss or a hardship without this person in my life, but how can I go to them and do this, right? Because yeah, they're not trying to hear this shit. This is the energy that's coming through you, and they know from the gate that someone is not trying to hear this, okay? They know that someone is not trying to hear this. I just got to put that out there. Aquarius energy is coming through strong here. Specifically, Yeah, I don't know what to do. Okay. I don't want to tell this person that I'm married if they don't know. Right. But I don't want to let go of them either. I want to take the chance, roll the dice, and try to figure this all out. But I just don't know what that looks like. Okay. We also have Uranus. Right. This person is very rebellious, very revolutionary. When I say rebellious, they like to do things that resort for them getting their way, no matter what type of situation is going on. So, you know, we also have Saturn energy here, right? They have a responsibility and a discipline to a certain situation, to that marriage situation, right? They may have stayed in that situation to get things to a certain point. These are the investments that they've made. Okay, but they weren't really honest about it, right? They were growing something with another person and may have been persevering for that situation and having a lot of patience for that situation. But this is something that may have kept them in a non-committed type of atmosphere with someone else. And no, they weren't honest about it. If someone is asking a question here, the answer is yes. Okay, they were not honest about any of this. I'm feeling Sagittarius. But this is the person that's pulling on your energy now because they're feeling some sort of way. Your third chakra may be a little blocked right now, baby, so you may need to unblock it. Okay, also your solar plexus may be a little blocked right now. You may need to unblock it. Okay, I'm also feeling here you got Taurus energy coming through. Some of you may be dealing with someone with Taurus in their chart, or they are. I feel like Sagittarius, you are waiting for things to come to fruition in your life. You have put in hard work that is now paying off. Your harvest, your rewards are coming to you now. I feel like that is what you're focused on. You're not focused on this person. I feel like you guys are inheriting gifts as well from the universe. You're going to need to cultivate them to grow to the person or the sorceress or the goddess I'm hearing that you need to be. Okay? So they want you to have patience with yourself. They want you to nurture yourself. And they want you to keep persevering on that level and on that path that you've been on. This is what's coming through. Okay, so sending you guys love and light, Sagis. You guys take care.